earnest and yet fetchingly debonair salutations to you all, my friends. Yes, I am wearing the same t-shirt.
Hideous.
Welcome to a very special,
very special
episode of Earthworm Jim Changed My Life.
All right!
Earthworm Jim 1 and 2 had incredible artwork, and I've always wondered, will there ever be a day where I can buy an original Michael Koelsch art? Well, the day has come.
Here's your chance to own Mike Kelsch's never before seen Earthworm Jim promotional artwork, Earthworm Jim 2 Redux.
November 2020 marked the 25th anniversary of Earthworm Jim 2.
Ooh.
And to celebrate the occasion,
Michael has opened an online store on his website, and he is selling this amazing, limited edition, never before seen Earthworm Jim art poster, Boxing Jim. You can purchase a standard Boxing Jim poster or a Boxing Jim poster signed by Michael Koelsch himself.
But you could do both. It's a world of choice.
For more information, please visit SporkUnltd's online store. For the uninitiated, Michael Koelsch is the original cover artist who illustrated the amazing retro-era 50s and 60s vintage-style airbrushed artwork for Earthworm Jim 1 and 2, promotional materials for video game magazines like GamePro, GameFan, Nintendo Power, Playmates Toys action figures, and the making of Earthworm Jim Launch the Cow. Do yourself a favor and check out Michael's portfolio on shannonassociates.com. Feast your eyes on these incredible samples from Michael's illustrations. It's unbelievable. Please visit Michael's website at www.SporkUnltd.com. That's SporkUnltd. Boxing Jim was inspired by the never-before-seen Earthworm Jim 2 cover art designs Michael pitched to Playmates Toys, the original publishers of Earthworm Jim 1 and 2, way back in 1995. Preparing for the launch of Earthworm Jim 2, Michael designed a series of three white comprehensive layouts that were simple, funny, and a little edgy to stand out on the shelves of video game stores. A comprehensive layout is the page layout of a proposed design presented by the artist to a client. The comprehensive layout shows the relative positions of both text and illustrations before the final content of those elements have been decided upon. It serves as a draft of the final layout and, if approved, is used as a guide for further design changes and ultimately production. Let's take a closer look at all three comprehensive layouts in detail. Earthworm Jim in a vintage boxing pose, reminiscent of Muhammad Ali's Skills, Brains, and Guts movie poster.
Let's get ready to crumble! Earthworm Fight. Jim!
Take this! Oh, hush up!
Earthworm Jim casting a shadow of bunny ears, or the number two. In Japan,
Earthworm Jim 2!
Jim doing the bunny ears was used in promotional Sega Saturn launch posters. Here's an original 8x10 artist proof of Jim doing the bunny ears with snot.
Yes. Wow! All I could ever do was a bunny!
Earthworm Jim in the Heisman Memorial Trophy pose with snot as the football. Here's a comparison of the real Heisman Memorial Trophy.
Gotcha.
For the 25th anniversary of Earthworm Jim 2, Michael has taken the comprehensive layout going full throttle into the 21st century. And now, we're getting a vintage-style boxing poster reminiscent of Joe Frazier versus Muhammad Ali's Fight of the Century. Promotional fight poster. In the early 90s, video game and toy packaging were filled with fluorescent greens and oranges, thanks to Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles. So Michael's brilliant idea for Earthworm Jim 2 was to create a game cover that was the complete antithesis. An all-white cover would make Earthworm Jim 2 pop off the shelves. Now let's go way back to the year 1995. The very first Electronic Entertainment Expo, E3, took place at the Los Angeles Convention Center. Earthworm Jim had a big presence at E3. Here he is socializing with an ass. And here he is at the Shiny Entertainment booth, promoting his own game. Hey, that's David Perry and Jim. Earthworm Jim 2 was playable for the first time at E3 and lauded in video game magazines, winning numerous Game of the Year awards.
Yes! Bravo!
Extra, extra, read all about it. Here's a newspaper scan of Brian Fargo, founder of Interplay Entertainment, and David Perry, president of Shiny Entertainment, at the Earthworm Jim 2 booth. Here's Doug Tenaple, creator of Earthworm Jim, poking the eyes of Accolade's Bubsy the Bobcat. Take that, Bubsy.
Okay, let me give you Groovy! And a Whoa, Nelly! And ow! Ow! I'm nude.
Mock-ups of the Earthworm Jim 2 game packaging designed by Michael Koelsch were showcased at the Shiny Entertainment booth. Now, if you pay close attention, these were the white designs of Jim casting a shadow of bunny ears, and it was originally going to be the retail cover art for the game.
Michael was absolutely right. Earthworm Jim 2's white covers stood out on the store shelves amongst all the chaos, and Shiny Entertainment loved the idea of a simple, straightforward cover. But Playmates Toys wanted a crazier cover art, with everything and the kitchen sink. Here's Michael Koelsch talking about the Earthworm Jim 2 cover art, everything and the kitchen sink. Let's take a look.
Yeah, Playmates had me do everything from the advertising. We did magazine covers for Nintendo, whole deal. Everything and the kitchen sink. That was actually the joke, and we got it past Playmates to do that. I think that was a Mike Dietz and I joke. We just figured because they kept changing. That was for 2.
Yeah, Earthworm Jim 2.
Yeah, that was the Sega one, I think. And we had tried simple, just easy, quick art, and then they said, no, we got to have everything, guns and the whole deal. It had to be fluorescent too at some point, but we talked about that. That was the days of, Ninja Turtles and stuff. So.
I absolutely love the Earthworm Jim 2 cover art. It's iconic.
We have a hunched, belligerent Earthworm Jim standing on a kitchen sink, armed with a mega
plasma,
with his pal Snot, inside Lorenzen Soil, which was named after Mark Lorenzen, one of the lead artists and co-author of the making of Earthworm Jim, Launch the Cow.
Here's a fun little trivia. Did you know there were two variants of the Earthworm Jim 2 cover art? Ever since I was a kid, I noticed there were differences between the multiple versions of the cover art of Earthworm Jim 2. Let's play
Spot the Difference. This is Earthworm Jim 2 on Super Nintendo. This is Earthworm Jim 2 on Sega Genesis.
Which is the original?
Let's start with the most obvious. You'll notice the frames of the character portraits have different colors. Red on the Super Nintendo and blue on the Sega Genesis. The objects beside the sink are different in both the Super Nintendo and Sega Genesis cover art. The Super Nintendo cover art has a magnet, and the Sega Genesis cover art has a doohickey? I'm sorry, after 25 years, I still don't know what that is. Perhaps Michael can enlighten me once this video is published. There's a heavy-duty helical spring behind the sink in the Sega Genesis cover art, and in its place is an extended pressure pipe in the Super Nintendo cover art. But do you notice anything else that's different? What about that olive green statue of Psycro inconspicuously placed in the Super Nintendo cover art? The Genesis cover art has a broken clock right above Jim's Mega
Plasma,
but it's missing in the Super Nintendo cover art. The shapes of the horizontal cracks on the walls of Lorenzen Soil are different in both the Super Nintendo and Sega Genesis cover art.
You're too good at this.
See, that's what I love about Earthworm Jim 2. Not only do the games contain substantial differences on each system, there's plenty of nuance in Michael Koelsch's artwork.
Plenty? Well, plenty is one of those funny words. You know, you say it a few times and it stops making sense. Plenty, 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 plenty. See what I mean? It sounds like a pneumatic hammer. See?
Last year, in May 2019, in Television Entertainment held a special Earthworm Jim 25th Anniversary Reunion live stream announcing a brand new Earthworm Jim game exclusively on the Intellivision Amico.
As a die-hard Earthworm Jim fan, I stayed up at 3 a.m. Malaysian time, and I was very fortunate to get one of my questions answered live on stream by Tommy Tallarico, Mike Dietz, and Doug Tenapel. Check this out.
Will Michael Koelsch provide promotional art for the game?
Yes, I've already talked to Mike and he's in.
Great. Yes, woo! So he is. He's in. That's great. That's a true fan right there. So Mike, those of you who don't know, Mike Koelsch did the original cartridge art of the Earthworm Jim like this. He did the original package art on a Genesis Nintendo games. He did all those beautiful airbrushed 90s style posters. We're going to have him come back and do that kind of cover on the piece.
I am overjoyed that Michael is coming back to provide promotional artwork for the new Earthworm Jim game on Intellivision Amico. And Tommy's absolutely right. I am a true fan.
You're the man, man, you're the man.
So that, my friends, is the never-before-seen Earthworm Jim artwork by Michael Koelsch.
Well, are they clamping?
A few of them. Most of them are just changing the channel.
If you're an Earthworm Jim fan like me, or if you love video game art, or if you consider yourself an art aficionado, you don't want to miss out on Boxing Jim. I also want to thank Michael Koelsch for responding to some of my emails and providing me these never-before-seen Earthworm Jim art assets for this episode. Thanks for watching this episode of Earthworm Jim Changed My Life. I hope everyone is doing well, staying safe, staying healthy. Make sure you practice good hygiene. I'll see you next time.
Health laws require that employees wash their hands before leaving the restroom. That's for saps.
Point.
Eat dirt, unhygienic lawbreaker!
Well, that'll learn ya. Our waitress will think twice before violating health laws again.